Hello, good evening, and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. Right, I am kind of, well, I don't know why I'm excited because I've never tried any of their beers. I don't think I might have done, but I can't remember trying them. I've just had a re-review of Nuki Brown. So anything that's going to kind of get rid of the taste of that and everything and the memory and the experience of that would be lovely. You know, I want that wiped out of my mind. Don't take long, not with my brain. So it's one I'm looking forward to that I love the sound of. It's Broughton. I'm not sure. Broughton, how it might be. It could be anything. And it's the English place names, isn't it? And names and everything else. It's a strange thing. You know, you can. It's like you look at Worcestershire. And we call it Worcester. Worcester sauce. Worcester. It doesn't make sense, does it? Anyway. Get on with it, Tel. This is Broughton Dark. I think there's a, ain't there supposed to be a little, what do you call it, either side of it? Apostrophe in it? I don't know. I always thought there was one that side. Dark, cloudy. Anyway, the usual stuff. What's this say? Main Street, blah, blah, blah. The little fat lady with the ponytail right there. I don't know what she's doing that for. Do something like that. It's a lot of stuff that don't really mean a lot. Suitable for vegetarians. Blah blah blah, balanced against the backdrop of Wakatu and Phoenix hops. Each pint contains one smooth shot of espresso. Nice. So that's gonna be nice. Now, first things first, you can get, although these espresso notes and coffee flavours and lattes and all sorts, without even using coffee. Pardon me. But there's nothing, I've got nothing against using, you know, add-ons and additives and things. It's all good. So it's got malts. This is one thing I do like. Malts, Pale, Crystal, Black, roasted barley and chocolate malt. Yum, 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 yum. Gives you all a little idea of what's coming. Hops, Fuggles, Phoenix and Wakatu. I don't even know how to say that. Yeast and water is Broughton's unique yeast and locally sourced Baldur's water. Specialities, cold pressed espresso and pinhead oats. So that's really, really lovely. I like that. Keep it up, fellas and brewers and things like that, anyone listening, because it really is important for customers. Here's the plain crown. Customers and that to know what's going in the beers and that, so that they can get a loyalty almost towards certain hops and certain malts. Not as much a loyalty, but they can, you know, you can see certain things, and it don't take long. People won't, you know, go, oh, I don't want to read that. They'll read it, and they'll go, oh, it's got that hop again, that one that we really liked before. Or it's got that, oh, that chocolate malt, that was lovely, and all that, you know. Right, sorry, I'll do rant and rave. Pouring out quite dark. It didn't make its own head, so I helped it along, and I've helped it a bit too far. So, you know, when it comes to all this fingers of head business and all that, I'm not having to go at anyone that does it. Don't take it personal, but it is a nonsense. You know, I've got two fingers in there, and I could have had no fingers. I could have had 10 fingers. I could have poured it up and down, and you know. But that's, I mean, what I do like, I like to see a head die down a little bit. But this has got, it's got oats, pinhead oats in it. And I think they're a bit like wheat for the stretchier proteins in it. Not sure. Someone will let me know, hopefully. This is a learning process for me as well. I read a lot of stuff, and I research a lot of stuff. But sometimes I just put something out there, and someone in the know goes, yeah, actually, they're this tell and they're that, and I'll go, thank you. And then I read up on it, you know. So yeah, look, nice fluffy head, lovely little fluffy head, velvety looking head, looks really nice. Dark, 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 slight ruby tinge to it, but dark. Tiny little notes, not massive notes, but tiny dark chocolate notes and espresso notes. Yeah, it's not like writing your bugle bosh like that. So I'm going to have a little taste because I think that this is going to be one of these pleasant little liars, you know, when you get it on your bugle and you go, nah, not much there. It's all right, but you know, and then you taste and you go, ooh. And I love beers like that. I like beers like that more than I do the aromatic beers, isn't it? Because they do a little lie and they sneak in. And I always say that they're like the old films when the lady used to take her glasses off and pull a pin out of her ear and right, and you'd go, oh, fuck it, all right, you know. Like, oh, Miss Jones, you do look gorgeous. And she'd go, phew. And yeah, it never looked like bedhead, you know. She'd go, and it was beautifully coiffed up and everything. Glasses, usually horn-rimmed glasses, used to come off. And ting, a big ting off her teeth. Sorry, I've gone off one there, haven't I? And yeah, away he went, he'd always wee, and he'd go. Never noticed her in the office, as if he wouldn't, you know what I mean? Right, let's have a taste. Cheers. Yeah, let's see if she's a Miss Jones. Oh, there's an interesting thing here about tasting beers. When I'm drinking that, not breathing out, it's you know, it's nice little flavours coming in, and then you breathe out and you get whack coffee and espresso, chocolate and espresso coffee, whack straight out, and they go through your nose and across the tongue. Without breathing out, you couldn't really pick them up. So it's always good to breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in before you, like that, before you actually get in your gob. So, like that. But stop breathing in, and so, yeah, like this. Yeah, so breathe it in, breathe it out, let it twirl around here. A little bit out through there as well. Lovely. Right, really lovely. The espresso note is kind of a slightly subdued. I would have liked to have seen a bit more. But it is really nice. It's kind of gently done. It's not too harsh. There's a nice little chocolate note in there. Lovely little chocolate note. Probably coming off the chocolate malts, but it could also be coming off the coffee itself. If you mix coffee with vanilla-y sort of notes, you get chocolate undertones. Because I'm not sure that coffee and cocoa, I'm not sure, they're completely different things, looking things, but I think there's some relation between the two, because the seeds look really similar. And there's, pardon me, a lot of similarity in the flavours. One comes in a great big fruit thing like that, as the cocoa, and the coffee's like little little tiny fruits, and they each got their own seed. But I'm sure it's they're of the same family tree. Someone let me know. Anyway, last little taste. Yeah, as you breathe out, you got little blackcurrant notes, little blackberry notes. You got plums and prunes. You got, but they're kind of subdued. Then you got a nice chocolate note, sort of the around the 30% chocolate notes, cocoa, little cocoa notes. You got it's kind of like a mocha. You know, you got cocoa and chocolate, but it's soft. Cocoa and coffee, but they're soft and they're mixed together, and they're almost milky as well, like vanilla undertones. So it's nice, really nice. It's not quite the big thing I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be a bit bigger, a bit more bulky. Let's see if there's any yeast in this, because I'm pouring a second lot in. A lot of the time, if you've got any yeast in something, it brings out a lot of flavours and stuff. No, there's no yeast in there. So I don't think we're talking bottle condition. But then a lot of stuff you buy in supermarkets and what have you ain't bottle conditioned anyway. And if it is, it's usually kind of, yeah, you know, it's like pumped up and in bottle conditioned. If that makes sense. It's kind of half and half. Right. Yeah, nice drink, really nice drink. And a lot of people will really love that. So what do I say? Bum 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 bum. Broughton's dark and cloudy. Buy it, try it and like it. Definitely buy it, try it and like it. I would like to see a little bit, it's slightly, you know, I'd like to see it just a touch more boisterous. Just a touch more kind of naughty and dirty and dark and all that, you know. Because it says dark and cloudy, and it ain't cloudy, and it's dark, but it's not like dark tasty, you know. It's not that animal that you expect it to be. But it is nice. So maybe I'll have to change the labelling and have it a little bit less like dark, pardon me, or change the beer a little bit and make it a bit darker. Not in colour, I mean on the palate. But nice, definitely nice, yeah. Try it, buy it and like it. Let me know what you think. See you soon, see you in the next one. Don't be late, be lovely, be good. Don't be late, because I will start without you. Biddly biddly bum.